Good morning all of you. In this session we are going to discuss about the morphology in flowering plants. It's very important in the NEET exam. They'll ask question 3 to 4 question. It's very important. So in the morphology in flowering plants, very important. In this chapter we are going to discuss about the introduction. Yes. Parts of flowering plants. Next we are going to discuss about the root system. Under root system we are going to discuss about the root morphology. Very important. Then we are going to discuss about the types of roots. You know very well that is types of roots, majorly 3 types. I will explain later. That is taproot system, next one is fibrous root system, and then adventitious root system. It's very important. Adventitious root system. And then we are going to discuss about the modification of the root. Special roots. And functions of the roots. So in the same manner we are going to discuss about the shoot system. It's very important. And the shoot system we are going to discuss about the stem, comma, leaf, and then flower, and then fruit and seeds. Apart from this we are going to discuss about the stem modification, leaf modification, and about the structure of the flower, types of the flower, modification of the flower. Next we are going to discuss the fruit and types of the fruits, and then seeds. Finally we are going to discuss about the families. Very important. We can expect the question from the families. So when you are coming to the families, that is Solanaceae family, comma, Fabaceae and Liliaceae. These are very important. Liliaceae. So these are very important. So in this also we are going to discuss about the families. So first we are going to discuss about the introduction about part of the morphology. Let's come to the point. See the first one. Introduction. So very important. First we should know what is the meaning of morphology. Morphology is nothing but study of external structure of plant parts like root, comma, stem, comma, leaf, and their modification to adapting to adapting different environmental condition, different environmental condition called morphology, called morphology. Now come to the next point, morphology, important of morphology. So when coming to the important of morphology, see the first one, it is useful for the identification of, plants in taxonomy. Very, very important in taxonomy. It is useful for the identification of plants in taxonomy. Next one is, it also helps in found variation in the plants. Very, very important. The next one, we are going discussing about the, so when coming to the intellectual part, the smallest plant in flowering plant, you know very well that is rootless. Aquatic plant, that is Ulfia, very, very important. Ulfia is growing up to 0.1 millimeter. Next, Lemna, it also aquatic plant. Grown up to the 1 centimeter. Next, very important, third one, Arsitobium. It is small dicot parasite grown on pinus and other plants. The next one is, this is the smallest plant in angiosperms. Next, tallest plant, tallest plant is, you know very well, that is Eucalyptus. So the plant grown up to 135 meters. Important. Next, largest plant, importance, when you come to the largest plant, you know very well, that is banyan tree, it also called Ficus bengalensis. It occupy 2.5 acres. Banyan tree occupy the 2.5 acres of the space. So very important, smallest, tallest plant as well as largest plants. So now we are going discussing about the plant habitat. Very important. Now come to the next one. Based on the habitat, plants are different type. Based on habitat, habit first we are going to discuss about the based on the habit. The plants are different type. Different types. See the first one here. Based on the habit, I am explaining. So when you come into the based on the habit, the first one, herbs. Herbs means these are small plant. Small plants growing less than 2 meters. Growing less than 2 meters. So when you come in, herbs are type there, that is annual plants. Annual plant example, you can take example here, wheat. Annual plant, they complete their life cycle within one season. Next, biennial plants, very important. Biennial plant means the plant complete the life cycle within 2 seasons. Example for this one, Hanabina, very important. The next one is annual plant, biennial plant, perennial plants. The plant growing from few years to the thousands of years. Example for perennial plants, perennial plants example, Hanabina. Growing up to the, growing from few years to thousand years. In case of perennial plants here, very important, perennial plants either underground stream or high water storage capacity. Important points. Now come to the second one. Shrubs, medium size plant. They grown more than 2 meters. Example for the medium size plant, jasmine and rose plant. But very important, in the shrubs, trunk is absent. So it is about the shrubs. Next one is trees. Trees, when coming to the trees, very important. Long, thick, woody plants called trees. Trees consist of a long, thick, woody part called as trunk. So when you come into the trunk, trunk either branched form or unbranched form. Now come to the next one, continuation point about the trees. In trees, trunk is either branched or unbranched form. Unbranched form of the trunk called as caudex or columnar. In case of branched form, excurrent. Example for the unbranched form of the trees, You can take example, cycles. So in case of your example, you can take example, pinus. Yes. Very important. Please write this point under the note. In some trees, trunk disappear after certain distance. After certain distance, and form into dome shaped structure. Dome shaped structure called as D current. Example, mango trees, banyan trees. Yes, so these are the example to the dome shaped trees. So it is about the based on habitat. The plants I given here, herbs, shrubs, as well as trees. Apart from this, other types. Please write this point under the note. So based on the habit only, some plants, pinus, that means weak stem plants, or creepers, prostrate plants, bears, roots at the node region. Or some plants, climber, yes, means coil structure plants. So these are based on the habit. The next one is based on habitat. Next one is based on habitat. So very important. So in the previous class we discussed about the based on the habit. Now we are going to discuss based on the habitat. Now see the first point. The plants are hydrophytes. Means those plants grow in the water we called as hydrophytes. Again, these are two types, that is seawater plant. Seawater plant example ma, very important, Zostera. And freshwater plant. Example, many there. That is hydrilla, vallisneria, pistia, icarnia, Nilambu, etc. Next, second one, mesophytes. So those plants growing on the land or terrestrial region, we call as mesophytes. Then third one, xerophytes. Xerophytes means those plants growing in desert region. So these are again two types. Dry habitat plants. Habitat plants. Example, acacia. Next, succulent plant. When coming to the succulent plants, very important. Succulent plant means they store water plus mucilage. Store water plus mucilage. Example for this one. Opuntia. Importance. Apart from this, please just keep in note here. Psammophytes. Psammophytes means those plants growing in sandy plants, growing on the sandy soil. Yes, this is better right. Fourth one. Fifth one, halophytes. Those plants growing on the saline, growing on the saline plant, we call as halophytes. So it is based on the habitat. The next one is based on lifespan. Very important. The types of the plants. Next point is based on lifespan. Based on lifespan. The plants are majorly three types, that is annual plants. When those plants complete their life cycle within a single season, we call as annual plants. Example for this one, wheat, paddy. Yes. Next, biennial plants. Those plants complete their life cycle in two seasons, we call as biennial plants. That is, first season we call as vegetative phase and store food material.